Let's Play Final Fantasy 14. I'm just back in Kugane because, well, I could attempt to do the samurai quest to show you stuff. They pretty quickly devolve into going to Kugane, and I don't think the first couple would be I'd be locked out of, but I think I'd get locked out of the 65 quest again, just like Dragoon. So, if not sooner than that, so just gotta continue the main storyline until we unlock at least the next area. They sort of expected people to ignore the job quests until close to the end of their leveling time anyway. That was like what this expansion like was so friendly about, was except for your level 70 skill, you got all your other skills up to that point without doing quests. Well, I guess it does have Ulda signs on it. But the building itself is made out of standard brick, and that's actually pretty unusual, honestly.
Our thaumaturges took great pains to ward these walls against all manner of surveillance. Where business dealings are concerned, we do not compromise on confidentiality. You may avail yourselves of these offices for the duration of your visit. Come and go as you like, and know that you may speak freely here.
Your offer is most generous, but I will not enter into any agreement which would leave us beholden to you or your master.
A legitimate concern? Allow me to clarify then. The chairman bids you consider this as an expression of his heartfelt contrition for the bloody banquet and the unpleasantness which followed. Never having been one to put stock in words alone, the chairman deems the provision of material aid to be a more appropriate demonstration of his sincerity. By sheer coincidence, your purpose here also happens to coincide with our own interests. That is, assuming you are come to aid the Doman Liberation Front.
How could... I will not bother to offer a denial. Aye, you have the right of it. To be specific, we are come in search of our Far Eastern allies, Yugiri and Gosetsu, whom we hope to assist in their fight.
The Aori Shinobi and the Rugadin Samurai? Then you will be pleased to know that they have both come to Kugane.
Are you sure?
Quite. They came here aboard a company vessel, you see. However, they encountered difficulties securing passage across the Ruby Sea.
The Ruby Sea? Sorry, I've never been any good at geography.
Forgive me. This calls for a map. We are here in Kugane, the sole open port of Higashi, situated on her western coast. Doma, meanwhile, is here on the eastern coast of Othard in Yansha. Therefore, if your friends are to reach Doma, they must first cross the Ruby Sea. Alas, this is easier said than done, as the Ruby Sea does not fall within the dominion of either Higashi or Doma, being controlled since antiquity by a third party, namely the Confederacy. Said maritime collective is known for the consummate skill of its sailors, and for demanding that any vessel entering its waters pay a toll referred to as the Ruby Tithe. In exchange, the Confederacy's vast fleet guarantees the safety of those who travel within its territory. Now, as I'm sure you are aware, Garlemald conquered Doma some 25 years past, at which time the Empire saw no value in controlling the Ruby Sea. And thus did they turn a blind eye to the activities of the Confederacy. The recently appointed acting Imperial Viceroy of Doma had other ideas, however. She has formally condemned the Confederacy and declared that any who recognize their authority shall be branded enemies of the Empire. Bowing to this pressure, Hingashi severed ties with these toll-takers and forbade the payment of the Ruby Tithe, prompting the Confederacy to make it known that any merchants choosing to sail the Ruby Sea would do so at their peril.
No wonder they struggled to secure passage to Doma. What captain would risk such a journey given the circumstances?
I am told your friends were not so easily deterred from their course, but I know not whether their persistence bore fruit.
I say we follow in Yugiri and Gosetsu's footsteps and attempt to secure passage to Doma for ourselves. We will need to cross the sea in any case, and we may learn something of their whereabouts in the process. And should we find that they are still in Kugane, we can make the journey together.
In that case, I have some information which may be of use to you. No quid pro quo, I assure you. The chairman was most insistent that I aid you to the best of my ability.
I like how everyone's basically like not sure about it. That's a good point. Alpha Nod is a man with a plan, huh? Oh, but he's actually a very good artist. I mean, other than Yugiri's scales being in black, because it's a, you know, it's a charcoal drawing, I guess. Pretty dang accurate. Now, why does Lisa's outfit have so many damn buckles? Look at these buckles. Sarah, look at these buckles. They're ridiculous.
Thank you.
I think she was trying to say onsen, right? And as she did. Hot spring, basically, you know. Kotokaze, huh? Gotta look that up real quick. Motion, change, freedom. Huh. Okay. Oh, she called us Aijin. Apparently she's a racist. I'm kidding, but seems legit. That's some glowy armor. That's the elemental armor from Eureka. We'll learn more about that way later. Hennish spice trader, huh? So he's from Thavnir? Kurt Captain. Looks like Gosetsu's the one doing all the talking, and Yugiri's staying hidden in the shadows. Like Todd in the shadows. No, I'm kidding, she doesn't do movie reviews. Or was it music reviews? Eh, whatever. My brother's really into Todd in the Shadows. He's got some interesting opinions on pop music, I guess. As long as you've got a catchy... some catchy editing and some nice voice and something to draw the eyes, you can make just about any topic into a YouTube video. We got to keep the sketch. It's probably a trap, huh? Namazu, huh? Good for catfish, huh? Tasogare Bridge, huh? Yeah, Clyde could probably pay our way. He's not exactly poor. What is his guild supply looking like? Yeah, he's doing just fine. He can probably pay the way. Sometimes I like to just run through Kugane rather than use the teleporters. Actually, more often than not I do. Despite it being such a large city and such, I still tend to eschew Aetherites for running through the city. You may have noticed I have a habit of pulling my map up repeatedly. Scheming moneylenders, huh? Punch him till he tells us the truth. Alice is a fan of direct action. Well, the Sekisei Gumi won't be any match for us at all, so, you know, it's kind of whatever. Oops, no, I wanted to talk to Lise. Oh, well. Okay, so Tatara's watching our back. That's nice. Shame there's not too much to make commentary on. Oh, but look, an instant battle. How about that? Well, it's not even nighttime yet. He said to come at night, so of course he wouldn't be here yet. What, you guys not pay attention to what I told you?
He's late.
Wasn't a time given either. It was just under the cover of darkness.
Endless and most sincere apologies to you and yours, yes, yes. This way, quickly now.
Enough! Where are you taking us? Where is the ship?
The ship! So very sorry to inform you, yes, yes. Long before was it pledged to another. To me! These ones are for Doma!
You snake.
I knew it couldn't be this simple.
Nothing personal, yes, yes, just business.
Then business is about to take a turn for the worse. Come on, let's find a way out of here.
I like how Lise has no concern, real concern for the Garleans. And to be fair, I mean, why would they be pose a threat just because they're wielding katanas? They can't beat us with guns and magitech armor. Katana's not gonna make a difference. Wider than the player one. We killed some Garleans. Now the Seki Sengumi will be after us if they find out. Of course, how could they have not heard the gunshots? Stealth section. Oh, smoke bombs, huh? Okay, this could be helpful. Now, that's how you do a stealth section, right? If you intend for them to do stealth, you have to force it. Otherwise, most players will just kill their way through everything. Unless they're just really dedicated to stealth for some reason. Which I never have been, so. Can I... I don't remember that being a guaranteed thing. We've got 9 smoke bombs. Could have sworn we were supposed to have 10, but oh well. This is one of those things where it's like it's sort of a stealth section, but not really. Ninja Turtle! Well, the turtle just looks like a beastman. You'd think she wouldn't be apprehensive towards, you know, beastmen, since there are so many of them in Eorzea, but then again, I guess she mostly dealt with the sylphs, so.
Stay hidden and quiet. Understood?
Clear the road! Clear the road! You there, Korjin. We seek four foreigners. One, a brutish woman carrying an unconscious Namazu. Have you seen them?
Brutish woman.
Four foreigners, you say? Ah, yes! Very rude they were, making no apology as they barged past. They went that way, I think.
Many thanks, good sir. With me, they cannot have gone far.
All is well. The Sekisei Gumi will not return this way for some time, I should think. You are of the East Aldenard Trading Company, yes? Come with me. I know a safer way.
Seems legit.
You are returned, and with guests, I see.
Our meeting went about as well as expected. We've brought the Namazu who thought to betray us. When he wakes up, we'll see what he knows about Yugirian Gazetsu.
Well done, you. When I saw the Sekisei Gumi out in force, I did begin to worry, but I see my fears were misplaced.
Actually, if it weren't for Soroban, we might not have gotten away.
T'was my pleasure.
Someone's sending me tells.
Yet I must ask, Soroban, why would you deceive the Sekisei Gumi to help us, foreigners of whom you know naught?
Why, out of the kindness of my heart, is what I would like to say, but my motives are not so pure. I chanced to witness your meeting with Hancock at the tavern and saw an opportunity.
An opportunity?
Like many, I came to Kugane as a trader to make my fortune. Korjin of the Red may serve the Empire as mercenaries, but Korjin of the Blue walk a different path.
But you're wearing green.
Regretfully, most here would rather not meet our gaze, much less do business. So I seek the custom of those less predisposed to dismiss us outright, namely the East Aldenard Trading Company.
Quid pro quo, is it? Well, there is no denying that we owe you a debt. What say you, Hancock? Will you consider doing business with our entrepreneurial friend here?
Rest assured, Master Soroban, that in matters of trade, the company does not discriminate. We would be honored to hear your proposal.
I promise you will not regret this, good sir. Ah, yes. You sought passage across the Ruby Sea, did you not? I have a ship you can use.
You do? Well then, far be it from us to refuse. You have our deepest thanks.
And you mine.
Very well. Making the catfish sing, huh? Perhaps you have left the sanctuary. Working on her interrogating skills. She's bad cop. I guess Clyde's good cop. Do catfish smell bad in real life? I've only caught like a few with my brothers and stuff, and I don't really remember trying to smell them. In fact, I've never leaned my nose down towards any freshly caught fish. I've smelled fish in the market, but, you know, never fresh. I kind of forgot about this. Having to go get Gosetsu out of Sekisegumi custody. So far he has been. It will not take long, he says. Waiting. Continue waiting. This time the waiting bar takes longer. I don't think any Garleans are going to come pouring out of the Sekisei Gumi barracks, so...
How about you?
Was that? That was Gazetsu. I'm sure of it. He's in trouble! Lise, wait!
I suppose we should follow her then.
That pause was a little too long. I'm still working on their dramatic timing, I guess, in this expansion.
Victory to the samurai! How many is that now? 10 in a row.
Gazetsu.
Oh, this is a surprise. What in blue blazes are you three doing here?
I could ask you the same thing. We've been looking all over for you, and then I suddenly heard you screaming.
It would seem there has been a misunderstanding. Allow me to explain.
So, in summary, you started a brawl with some off-duty Imperial soldiers and were subsequently arrested by the Sekisei Gumi, whom you somehow befriended and convinced to set you free if you could defeat a given number of them in single combat.
10 bouts for my freedom, aye. 'Tis but a pity you came too late to witness the last one. And with that, I'm free to go, yes?
Our word once given may not be broken, but we pray you make every effort to avoid future altercations. Circumstances notwithstanding, my lord, we are honored and grateful to have witnessed firsthand the skill of a Doma samurai.
Ah, and we had just concluded negotiations. I gather my assistance was not required.
Guess not.
But where is Yugiri?
To the Ruby Sea, huh? but where's the Ukiri? We want the Ruby Bazaar, right? Vile fiend, malevolent trickster, how kind the Kami are to grant me vengeance so soon, but first I demand you return the coin you so villainously embezzled from me. Lord Hien. Heir to Doma's throne. Does that say 12th or... I think it's the 12th, right? Is a black-hearted villainess who delights in the torment of our people. Must have a grudge. It's okay, Alphanod. You'll get your chance to travel with me again soon enough. I feel kind of sedated. Which I shouldn't, because, I mean, I had a whole sun drop, but, yeah. I did work out this morning. I've been doing weighted power walking. 10-pound vest and 6.5-pound dumbbells for my hands, and it comes together as 53 pounds more resistance on my body for walking. And I try to walk fast and swing my arms. It sort of winds up, you know, the walking motion turns into curls. And even with the low weight, it gets quite tiring, so one of these days, my goal is to get up to having the dumbbells be 25 pounds, so it'll take a while, but I'm feeling like next week I'll be able to move up to 10-pound dumbbells, and that'll make everything an even 60. Coming. New zone, new area. Woo! Now this is technically, you know, this is the third area of the expansion, so this is technically the Churning Mists of the expansion. Although it doesn't really have the same amount of gravity. Wait, no, I guess it would be the Dravanian Forelands of the expansion. Never mind.
I remember the water, how it turned crimson in the morning sun.
That's a high tower. Ooh, and magma, volcano.
A shimmering sea of rubies, stretching from horizon to horizon. You could almost believe it went on forever. But beyond that red expanse lay a land in turmoil. On the shores of Othard, our Doman brothers struggled in vain.
Man, why don't we just knock that tower over and aim it towards Ithelbard? Well, sure thing, Lys. I'll take a dip with you. When I first played through Stormblood, I had like, well, I wouldn't call it like a crush or anything, but I was starting to, yeah, Lys was becoming waifu material. Probably will. I mean, you had a head start anyway. But yeah, this is also the expansion where they introduced swimming into Final Fantasy XIV. And, you can actually go back and swim at... I mean, you saw it earlier in the Let's Play, but you can actually swim at Costa del Sol. I think I showed that off anyway. Not bad, we'll call it a draw. Well, the Aetherites seem rather close for some reason. Man, that tower is high. Goes up for as far as the eye can see. What, t-shirt contest? Well, Alice, that kind of pirate talk is actually all generated in Hollywood and by fiction. Actual pirates, you know, didn't talk that way. They were normal folks. Thank you. Uh-oh, we're finally starting to get an item level 265 gear. Well, we could go there, or we could go get those aetherites. Nah, we'll go there. I think it's a bit of a far swim. I don't know. Oh, no, I guess. I don't think the game will try to stop us, so I guess we could go get the aetherite. It could be the last thing I do in this video, considering there's not very much time left for things like cutscenes. Alright, we can see the aetherite from here. No, it's not that closer one. It's actually the further one. This is our only way across the water. Should the video cut out?